is adventure. Here's romance. Here's O. Henry's famous Robin Hood of the Old West, a Cisco Kid.
Mr. Vincent C. Emerson.
Oh, that's okay. Just call me Happy. Hey, dude, I bet you're itching to plug your first engine or maybe a bandit, eh?
Most certainly not. And I don't believe your tall tales.
Oh, you don't, eh? Well, take a look at that ridge on it and you'll start eating them worms. Them are real hold-up men.
Do something. Get out of here. Get going. Whip the horses. Get out of here.
Ah, we ain't got nothing they want, dude. Let them come on down here.
Are you fellas in for a surprise?
Keep your mouth shut, Grandpappy, and climb down. All right, Shorty. Climb out. Bring up them boxes, Joe.
War, nothing but sense war.
What?
Well, this looks more like it, boys.
That's a piece of junk. Nothing but a bunch of junk.
Oh, please, please, please don't. It's very, very valuable and very delicate.
Well, what's it good for?
It's a telephone.
What?
A telephone.
Well, what's a telephone? Oh,
you couldn't possibly know. This is Mr. Alexander Graham Bell's great invention, the telephone. There's another one just like it in the stagecoach, and it's possible to talk between them.
What are you talking about?
If you'll promise not to destroy it, I'll demonstrate for you.
All right, go ahead.
Will you please take that over there?
For you fellas, I'll bet you figured on guns or gold.
Shut up, you laughing hyena, or I'll fill you full of holes.
Hello? Hello? Can you hear me?
You see, the telephone works.
Now, may I continue on my way to San Francisco?
Hey, how far will this thing... Hey, how far will this thing work?
Oh, 10 miles, 15.
The blame thing really talks.
I told you to shut up.
Why, you killed him.
Yeah, and I'll do the same for you if you give me any trouble. Can't you hurry it up? We gotta get to the shack by dark.
If the telephone is going to work, I have to install the wires properly.
Well, never mind the talk. Just hurry it up.
Hey, Griff, come here. I wonder who them two men are.
Pancho, I'm disappointed in you.
Why, Cisco, really, the nice little dog.
Pancho,
We are going to take Rolito to the nearest stagecoach line and return him back to his owner.
Oh, Cisco, you want Rolito to lead a dog's life? If he had his own way, he would like to stay with Pancho. Goodbye, little fellow. I must go help Cisco.
You killed him, you fool.
Well, what about it?
Well, how are we going to work that telephone?
Don't worry about it. I know how to work it. But now we better get out of here.
He's dead, Cisco?
Yes, Pancho. Two bullet holes in his back.
Let's tell the sheriff.
Look, Cisco. Look who's coming, Cisco. Look who's here.
Cisco is right, Rolito. And now you go back to your nice, warm home, eh? If you hang around with me, maybe you don't get nothing to eat, or no bed to sleep in. You wouldn't like that, would you?
Pancho.
Is this dog ready to go?
I guess so. What's got to be is...
That's all right, Pancho.
Rolito will be better off.
Oh, would you identify the body?
Never laid eyes on him. If he'd ridden my stage line, I'd recognize him because of the fancy clothes.
A man has been murdered, and the sheriff would like to have everyone in town try to identify the body.
Very well. I've never seen him. What's your interest?
I'm always interested when a man is shot in the back, miss.
My Atlantic Gazette, please.
Oh, your magazine, of course. May I find your place?
No, thank you.
You'll have to wait a few minutes. The stage is ready to pull out, Miss Scott.
Oh? Well, let me have a dollar.
Well, I'm sorry, I don't have any change on it.
May I borrow a dollar?
Of course. But how far will the stagecoach take you for this?
Oh, I'm not leaving. Heads. I'm shipping the real gold dust today.
All right, Joe.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Would you mind explaining the tossing of the coin?
Well, finding the gold is a miner's problem, but shipping it out is ours. We've lost too many loads on the canyon road to hold up men lately, so I hit on this idea. My crates are always on the stage, sometimes with real gold and sometimes with just dirt.
And nobody knows which is which, eh?
Not until I flip the coin, and then it's too late to organize a holdup. Of course, if someone rode out of town after I'd given my orders, I'd be mighty suspicious.
You're a very smart young lady, but I promise you, I will not leave town until that stagecoach is miles and miles away.
Hey! If you need more room, my little doggy can go on the next trip.
Pancho.
Oh, Cisco.
All right, take her away.
Go!
Thank you.
Sure, I can hear you, Maddock. I told you this thing would work.
Listen, Griff, the gold dust just left here.
Good.
But this isn't so good. The Cisco Kid's in town. He's curious about a man with two bullet holes in his back.
So what? If he gets in the way, we'll handle him. I'll talk to you later. Come on, boys, we got a job to do.
You know, Cisco, I can't take my mind off of that little doggy. Let's do something, anything. Let's go find those killers.
How can we? We have nothing to go on. We don't even know who the dead man was.
Look, Cisco. Hello, little pobrecito. Where you come from, man? Eh?
Something must have happened to the stagecoach, Pancho. Come on.
Come on, Papa. You're going to ride with me.
Bad Rolito can't talk. He could describe the holdup men.
We saw you leave town and followed.
When the little dog came back, we were afraid something happened to the stagecoach.
Yes, Sheriff, I was worried too. I saw the dog.
The dog may have been a signal the gold was aboard. The other fellow wanted to take him off. You said no after you knew about the gold.
You keep my little doggy Rolito out of this.
You fellas better come back to town with us and explain a few things. Sorry you lost your sidekick, Rusty. I lost my best rider. These holdups have got to be stopped. And I propose to do something about it.
What, Malik?
Look.
Well, how do you know it was them? The sheriff says we ain't got proof.
We never had any trouble to lay hit town. That's proof enough for me. I'm gonna square Hank's death if I have to do it alone.
I'm with you, Maddock.
Hello, Mr. Maddock.
Howdy. Get their guns, Rusty.
What's the idea?
We'll show you what the idea is. We're gonna stop these stagecoach holdups around here.
You don't think that
we don't think we know.
All right, get a rope, boys.
Hold it. You run the town, Maddock, but I run the law. We got no proof these fellas are guilty.
And I won't be responsible for a lynching around here, Sheriff.
All right, then, we'll get him out of town.
How about our gun, Sheriff?
I'll take care of them.
Now go on, get going. Get, don't come back.
Griff.
Yeah, Maddock. What's on the road today?
Cisco and Pancho. Ride out and get them. We'll talk at our regular time.
Right.
Pancho, I'm going to stay here where I can watch the town. When the stagecoach pulls out, there must be a signal, a flash or a light or something that can be seen from the hills.
You see, Rolito? Cisco always got good ideas, eh?
You better ride to the other hill and watch the road. Maybe you can see something from that end.
All right, Rolito. You and Pancho, we go watch, eh? Come on in, little puppy. I find you a home, eh? You know, Rolito, this is a nice place to sit around while Pancho watch the road. You know, it is nice to be all alone by yourself with nobody around except my little dog people, eh? Griff, what's the matter? Why didn't you say, pop, pop, like always? Griff,
you got a cold? Let me look at your tongue.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello, hello. I didn't know you could talk.
Now listen carefully.
Well, I'm listening.
The Cisco Kid is in a glen on the outskirts of town.
I know.
How did you know?
What do you mean, how I know?
I'm not dumb.
What are you talking about?
Why, the same thing you are talking about. Pancho and Rolito
talk about the same thing.
Pancho?
Come on, Rolito. Let's go find Cisco. Until he hears you himself, he won't believe you can talk.
There's no sign of him at the shack, Maddox.
He's probably joined his partner. Now remember, you're a posse. Been on the trail of Cisco and Pancho for months. You gotta get the town riled up so that shoot on sight before those hombres get a chance to talk. All right.
Please, Rolito. Go ahead and talk.
Just say hello, that's all. Just a little hello. What's the matter, Cisco?
Nothing. Hey, Pancho.
What?
Did you go out in the sun without a sombrero?
Oh, Cisco, you think I'm crazy?
No, Pancho, but dogs can't talk.
Hey, but Rolito can.
Huh? Rolito? You're stubborn like a little mule, that's all. Hey, come on. Whisper to Pancho, come on. Hey?
I ask you like a little brother. Why don't you talk to me?
Hey, Pancho, I just saw Maddox surrounded by some new faces. Go back to the hills and watch the road.
Scott? You know who those men were who just left here with Mr. Maddox?
No, but I admit a certain curiosity.
Deputies. They've been on your trail for months.
Well, right now, I'm more interested in your magazine.
My magazine?
Yes, the one about, oh, there it is. I've seen this article before, but then it meant nothing to me. It's about the new machine, the telephone, and a man named Bell, who was the inventor. Please, Miss Scott, never shoot a man who has an unsatisfied curiosity. I am sure that this thing, this telephone, has been used to tip off the holdup men when the gold dust was being shipped out.
Telephone? What do you mean?
Well, I found a bell like this branded on the side of a crate that had been destroyed. Now I understand about the murder and also about the robberies.
You expect me to believe that a bell on a piece of wood is a proof for robbery and murder?
But I have more. My good friend Pancho, he has a talking dog.
A what?
He thinks the dog talks. It happened in a shack, which must be one end of the telephone. Now, if you don't shoot me, I'm going to try to find the other end in town. Oh, and thank you very much for not killing me.
Never mind, don't come snoopsing around. Because of you, Cisco and me is all mixed up in the murder. Stagecoach holdups, too. And because of you, Cisco thinks I'm crazy. Now go on. Go there and lay down someplace. Go on. Leave me alone. Never mind wagging your tail. Makes too much draft.
Come to the front.
also trapped in the express office.
Cisco is right. I'm going loco.
Ah! You keep out of this.
Pancho!
Pancho! Oh, so you're going to start that again, eh?
Listen to me.
Now you listen to me. Cisco's a smart man, and he say dogs can't talk.
But Pancho!
What do you want, to make a fool out of Cisco?
Of the two, you're the smarter one.
Pancho!
Cisco got himself in trouble again. You're the only one that can save him.
Well, how can I do this?
Ride fast to the back of the town and attract attention by firing.
But why?
Because I'm trapped in the express office.
Oh, there you go, you loco dog. How you can be trapped in the express office when you're sitting right here talking to me?
I mean Cisco is trapped. Now hurry up and do what I say.
Now you do sound like Cisco. Well, come on.
Deserted.
Drop your gun. You look better without it.
Oh, Sheriff.
Stop.
What goes on here? Drop that gun, Cisco. I thought I told you to get out of town.
I know you did, Sheriff. But we couldn't let Miss Scott go on being robbed.
What do you mean?
Well, Mr. Murdoch here will explain how useful a telephone can be in planning robberies. Go on, talk. Where must I help you?
Oh, I'll talk.
Cisco, here's some more hombres who want to do a little talking.
Come on.
I've had my eyes on you for a long time.
I'm sorry, Cisco. I was wrong about you.
That's all right, amigo.
Thank you, boys, for what you did for me.
Hey, pobrecito! You see, Cisco, you were wrong. And Rolito took as good as you and me. Now, go on. Show Cisco how you can talk. Talk, talk. You see? That means I love you mucho, Pancho.
Oh, Pancho.
Oh, Cisco.
Goodbye, amigos.
See you soon.